Damas y caballeros, ahora presentamos la entrada de los combatientes de la pelea principal de la noche. And now, ladies and gentlemen, we present the entrances of the principals in our main event of the evening. First, the challenger. Aquí está el retador, Tony, the Tiger Lopez. Champion, aquí está el campeón presentando Julio Cesar Chavez.
¡Adiós! ¡Arriba México!
Voz de la guitarra mía, al despertar la mañana. Quiere cantar su alegría a mi tierra mexicana. Yo le canto a sus volcanes, a sus praderas y flores, que son como talismanes del amor de mis amores. México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti, que estoy dormido, y que me traigan aquí, que digan que estoy dormido, y que me traigan aquí, México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti.
¡Venga! ¡Y arriba los reyes de Guadalajara!
Que me entierren en la sierra, al pie de los magueyanes, y que me cubra esta tierra que es cuna de hombres cabales. Voz de la guitarra mía, al despertar en la mañana, quiere cantar su alegría a mi tierra. Monterrey, por supuesto, y arriba Zócate Rizo, y que me traigan aquí, de México lindo y querido, si muero lejos de ti.
Gracias. ¡Viva México! ¡Viva Julio César Chávez! ¡Viva Monterrey!
Roy Guerra with his usual stirring rendition of the inspiring song México Lindo as Julio César Chávez makes his way finally into the ring. Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. and Omar getting a lot of television time tonight as well, as they are also brought in on the shoulders of Julio's people. Here comes Chavez. So Julio Cesar Chavez looking to make it 93-1-1, comes in with 78 knockouts, 31st career world championship fight. This big crowd here at the baseball stadium of Monterrey standing by. Time now for a check of the numbers as we go to the tail of the tape. And both almost mirror images in terms of the figures at 32. Chavez just 1 year older than Lopez. The height exactly the same at 5'7 and a half. Chavez 140, Lopez 139. The reach nearly even to the rules. WBC title fight. 10-point must scoring system. Three judges will score the fight. No standing eight count, no three knockdown rule. Only the referee can stop the fight, and a fighter cannot be saved by the bell except in the last round. So here at the Estadio Baseball de Monterrey, we are getting set for the WBC Super Lightweight Championship. Julio Cesar Chavez versus Tony the Tiger Lopez. Let's go back to our ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon Jr.
Señoras y señores, favor de ponerse de pie para escuchar los himnos nacionales. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we present the national anthems. Primero, el himno nacional de México. Aquí está el cantante y comediante internacional, Tony Flores.
Mexicanos al grito de guerra, el acero a prestar y el bridón, y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Ciño patria, tú sienes de oliva, de la paz, el arcángel divino, que en el cielo tu eterno destino, por el dedo de Dios se escribió. Mas si osare un extraño enemigo, profanar con su planta tu suelo, pienso patria querida que el cielo un soldado en cada hijo te dio, un soldado en cada hijo te dio. Mexicanos al grito de guerra, el acero a prestar y el ridón, y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón.
Patria, patria, tus hijos te juran exhalar en tus aras su aliento. Si el clarín con su bélico acento los convoca a lidiar con valor. Para ti las guirnaldas de oliva, un recuerdo para ellos de gloria, un laurel para ti de victoria, un sepulcro para ellos de honor, un sepulcro para ellos de honor. Mexicanos al grito de guerra, el acero a prestar y el bridón, y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. Y retiembla en sus centros la tierra al sonoro rugir del cañón. ¡Viva México! ¡Viva Chávez!
Muchas gracias a Tony Flores. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of the United States, presentamos el himno nacional de los Estados Unidos. Damas y caballeros, bienvenidos aficionados al box al estadio de béisbol Monterrey por el campeonato peso superligero del CMB. We welcome you, ladies and gentlemen, to the main event of the evening, Judgment Day in Monterrey, brought to you by Don King Productions and New Shows Incorporated, along with King Vision and SET Pay-Per-View. This bout is sanctioned by the World Boxing Council Presidente José Suleiman, Supervisor Eduardo Lamazón, along with La Comisión de Box y Lucha de Monterrey, Presidente José Juan Guerra. Presentando a los jueces, introducing to you the judges scoring this bout from ringside, Nicolas Hidalgo, Harold Lawrence, and Daniel Vanderweer. Bien amigos, esta es la pelea principal de la noche de 12 asaltos. All right, fans, here we go with the main event of the evening. And now, ladies and gentlemen in attendance, boxing fans joining us around the world, it's showtime! The WBC Super Lightweight Championship of the World, scheduled for 12 rounds of boxing. Aquí está el referee, the referee in charge, Luis Carlos Guzmán. Presentando al retador en la esquina azul, presenting to you first the challenger. On my left, fighting out of the blue corner, entering the ring wearing gold trunks with black trim, el peleador de Sacramento, California, en los Estados Unidos. Con un peso de 63 kilogramos, he weighed in at a ready 139 pounds. Con un récord de 45 victorias, 4 derrotas y un empate, tiene 32 victorias por knockout His record includes 45 wins, 4 losses, 1 draw, with 32 big wins coming by way of knockout. He is ranked the number 2 super lightweight contender by the WBC. Here's tonight's challenger, the outstanding former 3-time world champion, presentando al retador número 2 en el mundo, aquí está el Tigre, Tony the Tiger Lopez. Y su rival, al campeón. In La Esquina Roja, his opponent across the ring, fighting out of the red corner on my right, wearing red trunks with gold trim, el hijo de la República Mexicana, representando Culiacán, Sinaloa. Pesando 63 kilos y 500 gramos, his weight at an even 140 pounds. Con un sobresaliente récord de 92 victorias, una derrota y un empate, tiene 79 ganadas por knockout. His fantastic and outstanding record includes 92 victories, only 1 defeat, 1 draw, and 79 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the legendary 6-time world champion in 3 weight divisions, the current WBC super lightweight champion of the world. Demos la bienvenida al campeón, el gran campeón mexicano, el único, Julio Cesar Chavez. Aquí está el referee Luis Carlos Guzmán.
Cuando yo diga break, paso 3 sin pegar. Suerte a los dos.
Luis, es posible, espero para...
So here in Monterrey, Mexico, Julio Cesar Chavez looking to defend his WBC super lightweight title against Tony the Tiger Lopez. His first fight in Mexico, his fourth fight at 140, the first two to destroy his opponents, the third against Haugen. He does have power at this weight. The third man of the ring is Luis Carlos Guzmán of Argentina. There's the bell. Round one scheduled for 12. Tony Lopez wearing those long Archie Moore-type trunks. Chavez in the red with the gold trim. We were informed prior to the broadcast, Chavez on 92-1-1 with 79 knockouts, not 91-1-1 with 78. The update provided to us by the Chavez camp, the mystery fight, Jose Medina. He fought him once in 81, allegedly once in 82, a TKO round 6. It was not credited previously.
He wants to get to that 100 fights quicker.
Indeed.
Not a thing unknown in boxing.
Chavez's trainer, Emmanuel Stewart, says Julio will look to box more. Ferdy, I think that's what he told you.
Yeah, he thought that as long as he's coming in, he doesn't have to go search and look for a guy. He can go back to boxing. Emmanuel Stewart says, I was shocked at how good this guy can box. He's not always just punching, but I think when the chips get down, he'll return down to what he was. That's punching to the body and punching to the head with those left hooks.
We saw him do that against Frankie Randall, but Bobby, probably more out of necessity.
I think it was out of desperation. I think he was getting beat at his own game, beat on the inside. He was getting out punched. He was getting hurt. And I think that he was forced to do that. And he did win a couple of rounds that way, but it was so out of character. It's the only time I've ever seen him do it. I don't think Julio Cesar Chavez is at his best doing that. He's the epitome of a search-and-destroy fighter, dismantling his opponents round by round, stronger as the fight continues. And that's just not Chavez to box from the outside.
Lopez told us yesterday he plans to start off by moving until it heats up. And as Bobby points out, Chavez, a notoriously slow starter, Lopez looking to take advantage of that. He feels that Chavez has slipped a bit. He will look to unload body shots, uppercuts. The crowd obviously getting behind their idol, Julio Cesar Chavez.
Yeah, he said he wants to work the body. He said you have to pay a price to do that. He said, but everything you have to pay a price for, and if the reward's worth the risk, he said you do it.
The chance of Chavez. You'll recall Taylor slowed Chavez with shots underneath. Lopez feeling that Chavez's body is softening. But you do pay the price sometimes against Julio.
Very few people do go to his body because it is so costly.
Keep an eye out for Lopez's right hand. The right hand of Frankie Randall was effective against Chavez, who couldn't get out of the way of it. Lopez has a good right.
I don't think he's got the speed and accuracy of Frankie Randall. He's more a brawler, mauler, come in there punching all over the place. I don't think he's got the accuracy with the right hand that Frankie has to land it on as good a fighter as Julio Cesar Chavez.
Interesting. Randall started fast. That was his game plan against Chavez, and Julio did not respond well to that.
Well, he forced Chavez into starting fast, which is not characteristic of the way he likes to do things. Lopez, on the other hand, likes to close faster.
Round one in the books.
Uneventful and boring round after all the action we've seen, but that's not unusual. Let's listen.
I want you to stand out there, move, and leave that head. You keep on moving that head, side to side, okay? You try to come over a couple of times with the right hand over the jab. You got out with perfectly, okay? That's why you keep that head down, that shoulder, that fan, fan. You know what's going to work on this side? That left hook, right hand, okay? Fan, okay? We got time, okay? Let's go. Okay, take
but it's okay. You're looking good. Very good.
In the middle of Spanish, and Emmanuel Stewart's English, his little boy said, "You're hitting him good, Dad." That was it. That was three voices in there.
Round two. Now, historically, opponents of Chavez who go toe-to-toe usually find trouble, but Lopez told us, hey, I've done that my entire career. I'm not about to stop now. He said he'll play right to Chavez's strength.
It's very difficult to judge the first few rounds of a fight as to how it's going to go, because Chavez many times just given away the first couple of rounds as he watches, comes in, and starts to solve in his mind what he has to do. So the first few rounds might not be totally indicative of what happens.
Almost always. I mean, even with easy fights, he just kind of whittles away those first two or three rounds looking for the openings he wants. And when he gets in gear, then it's a different fight.
Between these two fighters, there has been only one knockout. Lopez KO'd in 89 by John Molina. Chavez, of course, has never been knocked out. He was knocked down for the first time after 90 fights last January by Frankie Randall.
Some nice defensive maneuvering by Tony Lopez.
Tony's being very cool. He's boxing with a lot more concentration and a lot more steadiness than I've seen him before, because he usually comes in winging.
He's using a real throwback to the fighters of old.
Yeah, he's a serious fighter. He wants to get in and mix it up like as does Chavez, but right now he's being smart. He's using a good stiff jab, not just a token jab. He's putting it in there.
And he's a throwback in the sense that he doesn't keep his hands up to catch punches. Instead, moves his head or body, then counters and usually makes his opponent pay when the opponent misses. Uses a lot of shoulder jukes and head feints. Nobody's landed, made it 30. In round two.
Lopez said he's going to have to watch the double hook. He said that is Chavez's best weapon, hook to the body, hook to the head.
Lopez has a powerful left hook, solid and accurate right hand. Against Haugen, he was often leading with his right, not setting it up with the jab, coming right in and doing it effectively. There's a right hand by Lopez, but doing no doubt, right hand by Chavez.
More of a glancing blow, though. That didn't really connect all that solidly.
So things beginning to open up just a hair now.
Not much.
Not much. Just a bit. Keep in mind, Lopez historically susceptible to cuts. He sustained a wicked cut over the left eye against Haugen from a headbutt in round eight. He told us he usually cuts from punches, though, not headbutts. And we know from headbutts with Chavez and Randall. Now left hand that managed to get through by Chavez. That one landed.
It was a good clean shot. You see Lopez shook it off. Not a real big deal. He's got a good chin. He's a durable guy. He's here for the duration.
Or as close to it as he can get.
That's true. He's here. He intends to go to distance.
And that is it for round two.
And that might have opened a cut on his eye.
There is blood over the left eye.
That punch
of Lopez.
The last punch came right at the bell, and it opened that pop, that eye that opened with Haugen. I thought that thing was too deep to not open. But that was almost like by accident.
Right on cue, Purdy, as we were talking about it in the final seconds of the round.
Oh.
the race, man of the race.
We can't quite see in there, and we did see the blood spread out, and they're working on it, obviously. But that's going to be the problem that Tony faces.
His blood got seepy.
Let's take a look at it and do a little detective work. He's not cut up to this point. And when the bell rings, there's the shot. And the bell has just rung. And look at the red. Look at the red there.
Nice show of sportsmanship, but I'll tell you, that's a bad eye.
Yeah, because I don't think he even felt it open. You know, that was a bad cut when he was fighting Hogan. That was like 6 months ago. Not enough. When you're in with Chavez, Chavez is going to pop that eye open. That's what I thought. This would go to the middle rounds and probably stop with a cut.
So that was round 8 in the Hogan fight. This happening on the last punch of round 2.
And Tony's got the message. He says, if that's going to be the case, let me get started now.
Good right hand he landed on the corner of Chavez's chin.
Keep your punches up, says the referee, Luis Carlos Guzman, to Lopez. Lopez with the left jab and a right hand, but a glancing blow by Chavez. Lopez, the challenger, 45-4-1 with 32 knockouts, three-time world champion. Chavez now 92-1-1 with 79 KOs. WBC super lightweight champion. Going to the body now is Julio Cesar Chavez. Not having much effect on Lopez. It goes to the head. Maseca, that is a flower company sponsoring Julio Cesar Chavez. That's what it says on his trunks. And how about Lopez's trunks? He's a walking advertisement for Sacramento Cable. Oh, right hand by Lopez.
Nice right hand. That not only got Chavez's attention, it bothered him a little bit.
Midway through the third.
And if he makes him mad enough, this is going to start to heat up for a real fight here pretty soon. Right now, Tony Lopez is doing all the fighting, as if he's gotten the message, you better get started. He's got a cut already. Better get started.
That one missed. Good left, doubling up Chavez again.
Chavez using a little bit better jab today than he has in the past.
He's boxing him with a great deal of coldness. I mean, there's no fire in here. He's just boxing. This almost what Emmanuel Stewart said he's going to do. I mean, at the beginning.
Cold is the operative word.
Yes,
outside the ring, it is cold.
He picked a good night to box cold.
Very fitting. That's a miss by Chavez over the top. It is in the 40s right now. I'd say the mid 40s.
It is cold.
Listen. Little uppercut there by Lopez sneaking through. Lopez pressing the attack, moving Chavez back into Lopez's corner. There's a right hand though by Chavez in the process, and left by Chavez.
Nice counter right by Lopez there coming out. See, Chavez is so deceiving on the inside. He lets all those punches slip off his gloves and his shoulders, and he doesn't get hit clean.
And no blood from the left eye of Tony Lopez. There was another Lopez on the card tonight, no relation to Tony, earlier this evening on the undercard here at the baseball stadium in Monterey. Ricardo Lopez. Here's Ricardo on the left of your screen. He defeated Yamil Caraballo by knockout. Watch the right hand coming up. Oh, a ferocious right by Ricardo Lopez at 110 of round number one. And Caraballo sprawled out on the canvas. That was it. As Lopez retains the WBA strawweight championship, he has held this title longer than anybody else, more than 4 years. Lopez, one of boxing's hot rising stars, also assisting tonight in our Spanish simulcast with blow-by-blow announcer John Gonzalez. John, on the left of your screen, and on the right of your screen, alongside Ricardo, former welterweight champion Carlos Palomino. So congratulations to Ricardo Lopez. Round 4 of this WBC super lightweight championship.
And this is about where Carlos says, okay, Chavez says, it's time to do a little fighting now. This is about the time he gets serious.
I'll tell you what, one of those right hands seemed to start the closing of Tony Lopez's eye. Got purple and nasty right away. It's very swollen over the top of his left eye. Could be a factor in a few rounds, a big one.
The first round was slow pace. Nothing happened. The end of the second round of the last punch, Chavez opened a cut over Lopez's left eye. The left eye that was opened up in the eighth round on a headbutt against Greg Haugen. Chavez going to the belly. But those punches are sliding off. That right hand blocked neatly by Chavez.
Chavez letting him out of the corner with just a little toll gate punch there to the body. You're going to leave? Well, here, take this with you.
Wild right hand by Chavez. He does have the vicious right if you followed his career, plus the legendary left hook.
Yeah, that left hook is his bread and butter. That's his make-the-money punch, too, to the body, to the head, the way he rips it constantly.
That's his trademark punch. He's always coming forward, relentless, economical puncher, and he can really take a punch.
We have not seen him hook as effectively as we have all the other fights where he rips it to the body and then to the head, and that's coming up in future rounds because that's the way he fights.
Lopez still trying to get some of those body shots in, move, and jump in with a 1-2, but I think right now he's doing a little too much moving. He's got to set himself and get Julio's, not only his tension, but his respect with a couple of those bombs.
Less than a minute remaining in round four.
Here comes up, but hook twice to the body defense.
Now Chavez moving in, but Lopez able to push him out of there. There's the left jab by Chavez. But good head movement by Tony Lopez to elude. Low blow there by Chavez. Let it go.
You know, Tony Lopez is not only a likable guy, he's a likable fighter. Always comes to give his best, whether it is a boxing performance or a brawling performance. Serious about his trade. And tonight, chance of a lifetime and the job of a lifetime ahead of him.
And he wants to go back to Sacramento, a conquering hero.
Deep breath. Good, good.
Yeah, the movement, you give him movement, you fuck him up. Okay?
Give him movement. I want you low. You're still a little bit too high. I want you low.
And he comes in, and you ain't moving. You got this big step, bam, bam, bam. I want 3-4 punch combinations, follow even move. Okay? When he's coming in, you're not setting yourself. I want it. When he comes in, that's when you, just like you did on the mid. Okay, what we're doing in the back room right there, you need to do it in here. Okay? And it's not one punch. 2, 3, 4, 5 punches, okay? And move. I want you low all the time. You gave him movement, you threw him on.
Okay, he's breathing hard
movement.
Now.
All right, deep breath,
Tom.
One deep breath, let it out.
He's breathing hard,
pal. Right under.
Well, you heard Sal Lopez Jr., the brother of Tony Lopez, saying it's not one punch. It's 2, 3, 4, 5 punches. That's what's going to do it as we go into round five. Julio Cesar Chavez, the champion in the red. Tony Lopez, the challenger in the Tony the Tiger trunks. And they are long. Good right hand there. Look out. Tony Lopez almost slipped on some moisture from his own corner.
There's a lot of water over there coming off his trunks and him.
A lot of movement here from Lopez. Dancing around side to side. A lot of head feints and a right hand, but not much there. Looking to measure Chavez out.
Pace is actually a little slower than you might have figured with these two styles and these two fighters.
I think that's because Chavez isn't accepting the invitation to the dance. I mean, he's still boxing around and doing, you know, looking nice and not inflicting a lot of damage.
Pretty good right hand there, but Lopez also, like Chavez, has a very good chin.
You got to be quicker than that.
Yeah, Chavez always gives the impression he's in no big hurry. He knows he's going to get the job done. He'll just slow walk you down, as we say.
Lopez invites the toe-to-toe brawling style, no matter who it's against, even Julio Cesar Chavez. He likes people draped all over him. That's his style of fighting.
Well, he's doing a little more moving in boxing today, a little more of defensive work with his feet.
He said he would plan to start out by moving a lot until the action heats up. Round five continues.
Uh-oh, he comes right in.
But a right hand by Tony Lopez, as we were expecting Chavez. Pretty good combination, right uppercut, left hook by Lopez. But Chavez didn't flinch.
Well, there don't seem to be much steam in his punches. I mean, Lopez doesn't look like he could hurt you with those punches.
I don't think he's loading up on him right now. He's looking to just get him in and keep Chavez away.
The action heating up a bit here as the crowd gets into it. Now Lopez spinning Chavez around.
And Chavez using his forearm and his elbow. You know,
he does it all the time.
Oh, he does that very well. There's a nice right hand right in the butt.
Cuts gloves and then a right hand by Chavez.
All right, here comes Chavez.
Chavez really unloading there. And Lopez again showing the sportsmanship, acknowledging Chavez, touching gloves.
Well, it doesn't seem to be any bad blood between these two. Just business and opportunity ahead of them.
Again, good defense by Chavez, blocking those punches with his fist.
Oh, and a right hand.
A solid right hand by Julio Cesar Chavez in the final seconds of round five.
Emmanuel's trying to tell him in English and the other one's translating it. Doubles and triples to the head, but he's going to do it, not just one punch. I think Chavez has just opened shop for the night here, and this is the flurry that indicated he's back in business. Time to go to work. Incidentally, corner work very, very, very good on the cut of Tony Lopez and has not opened further, and that's a miracle.
But that eye is still getting ugly.
Yeah, and uglier by as it's swelling now, not only just getting red and not only just being cut, but swelling.
We saw that familiar pose of Chavez ready to uncoil back into the fray. Round six, coming off a solid round for the champion.
I'll tell you, coming off the three fights we've already had, this is almost anticlimactic.
We saw some great action earlier tonight, beginning with Jorge Castro's comeback win over John David Jackson. Right hand by Chavez. Right on the head. But they have done a great job over the left eye of Tony Lopez. That's Jacob Duran, the cut man in Tony's corner. Had a cut that came in the final seconds of round two on a punch from Chavez.
It was just a tiny, tiny leak, like a leaker, they say. Just one or two drops came out, and they closed it very well. But that eye is still getting bad. You see what Lopez is doing, too, is he pulls into Chavez and ties him up on the inside, as opposed to being caught on the tail end of his bomb.
Lopez getting virtually nowhere when he punches to the head of Chavez. Let's see if he tries to go underneath, but that's where you really pay the price. And now Chavez going to Lopez's head.
Chavez picks it up whenever he gets in close and he wants to fire. He picks it up, and you see the difference in the steam of fight of the punch and the accuracy of the punches. Look at that. That is a Chavez punch. Left to the hook to the side, left to the head. That is hit prime championship punching by Chavez.
Yeah, Chavez wastes very little. He's on the mark with most of his punches, and that's why you see the damage that just keeps mounting him on the mark.
Chavez chasing.
He's beginning to land that right hand with good accuracy to the side of Tony Lopez's face, and it's starting to stop him, and if nothing else, it's going to swell that eye shut, which is getting him every round a little bit worse.
Right hand lead by Lopez. Again, having no impact. This is a pretty good right hand by Lopez. Oh, what a right hand by Chavez. Flush on the face of Lopez. Now loading with the left. missing with that left. Good head fake by Lopez to elude. Less than 30 to go in the round.
Besides being tough, Lopez does have some good defensive skills. He slips, he moves, he makes close glance. But he's in there with the master today that just may be too much for him.
Well, today he's testing his heart, and there's nobody ever doubted his heart. Lopez has got a big, huge heart.
His first shot at a super lightweight title, three-time world champion from Sacramento, California, rated number 2.
Punches more. I want you to start putting some hurt on him now, okay? Start putting them down. Bam, bam. Just like you did in the mist, okay? You catch him when you hurt him, okay? Movement. Keep them. You got to keep the movement up. I like to move. When you stop and punch, you stop and you throw. And then you move. Okay? Keep that down. I want you to jab. Keep that jab. Bam, bam. Jab. Jab, okay? Left hook, right hand.
Perfect tonight. Beautiful. Okay.
All they're telling Chavez is, when you finally stop the fight, put everything you got on it. Let's get this guy out of here. In the meantime, continue to box until you get your opportunity. You're satisfied with what he's doing. Why shouldn't it be? He's winning the fights.
Round 7, so we've hit the halfway point, fellas. How do you have it scored unofficially?
I've got Chavez ahead, 58-56. What do you got, Bob?
I have it the same way. I only gave Lopez the first round and the third round, and not by a lot. There hasn't been any runaway rounds, but Chavez is clearly taking control. Although Lopez has come out this round with some combinations, several straight right hands and 1-2s. He's coming to fight this round.
Yeah, he's going to lay it out. It's getting better here. It's getting hotter in this cold night.
Getting a little more frantic now as Tony Lopez takes the initiative here in round 7. His brother Sal told him to keep the movement up, but he is beginning to go toe-to-toe now with Julio. And a combination by Tony Lopez,
you know,
who really
picks
it up.
I'm sorry, Steve. You know what he's doing is he's pushing Chavez back. He's just forcing him back, not letting Chavez come forward and deliver his power. Just at all costs, push forward. And not a bad strategy right now.
No, but
vintage Tony Lopez. That's his fight. Come forth brawling like that. But it'll only get you so far with Chavez.
Every once in a while, Chavez does sneak in that little crisp uppercut. But Lopez does have the solid chin. The right hand, a glancing blow by Lopez. He continues with this form of strategy, but Chavez is landing. Lopez continues to press the attack. Chavez backpedaling, but getting shots off.
Right, but Lopez is getting hammered with those hooks. Little hooks and uppercuts are devastating on the part of Chavez.
Crowd urging Chavez on. Right hand. Oh, there was an uppercut by Chavez that sent Lopez's head back.
This is a Tony Lopez type of fight. And although it was very effective in the first minute of this round, it's starting to dwindle a little bit. He's getting hit more cleanly on the inside.
Left hook by Julio. His punches aren't having much impact on Chavez. And while it looks like Lopez is pressing the attack, Chavez is landing more. Like right there.
And there. And there. He gets effective, and boy, then he gets into a rhythm.
And a left hook by Chavez. Very meaningful. Chavez unloading. Joaquin Lopez comes back.
No quitting Tony Lopez. He got hit with a real good shot that stunned him. Look at that right hand he landed.
Good right by Lopez to the head of Chavez. And now some.
Now Chavez is really mad. Now it's mad. Now they're getting mad. Oh, look at the eye of Tony Lopez.
Chavez just gave him a good elbow and a butt.
Big finish to round 7.
And you fought as long as Chavez is. He uses everything in the ring.
As bad as Benny Briscoe? 1-2, elbow, elbow.
Bad news in Tony Lopez's corner. Let's listen.
We need the pressure. Okay. Now, okay, you know what you're not doing? You're not saying that you're sit down on your punches. Make everyone count on. And you're not covering up after you throw. You throw, you got your hand down here. You throw, pick this one back up. You throw, start bending them knees. Okay? You
You can be, you're beating his ass. Look at that eye, Tony. You're beating his ass. Okay, but you can't. You're trying to.
Let's take a look at a master at work in the corner. He makes everything count. He look at this. You know what? It's amazing that Tony Lopez has been able to take this kind of punishment. He really got belabored there. Take a look at this, Bob.
Yeah, I know. He's on the inside, and Tony likes to kind of invoke this type of wrath from his opponents, but not a Julio Cesar Chavez. He's too sharp. He's too clean. He's too accurate, and you don't get to hit him often enough cleanly, and certainly when you do, it doesn't always have any effect at all.
Well, look at the, look at the face of Julio Cesar Chavez. He looks like a racehorse waiting for the gate to open.
Or a lion, the lion of Culiacan.
Cover up. Go two, three, four, cover up.
Hard to hear the doctor. He did point with one finger, almost like saying one round more.
Side to side, movement. Don't stay in the corner.
Now the doctor looking very closely. We begin round eight. They even delayed the start of that round because the doctor wanted to check things out. They delayed it by 33 seconds. Well, Chavez forced to work inside of the last round, and he proves he can connect there, too. And a sense of urgency for Tony Lopez after a visit from the doctor.
They were hollering so much in the crowd that you couldn't hear with the doctor, but he held that finger up, and it sure looked like one more round I'm going to give you.
As has always been the case, Chavez's punches are damaging. Look at Tony Lopez's face.
And Chavez aiming and stalking. A cut that opened on the last punch of round two from Chavez.
Chavez got a little bit of a swollen jawbone underneath his left eye, too, from maybe Tony Lopez's right hand or two.
Well, if it wasn't Tony Lopez, I don't know who it was. Somebody hit him. Oh.
Now it's Chavez up on the balls of his feet, doing the pressing, as opposed to the last round, although either way, it's been effective for the champion.
Watch the butt. The referee says, I didn't see that bad of it.
Lopez says, okay. Lopez doubling up on the jab.
So whenever you fight a fighter that jumps in and out, leaps in and out, and springs at you, that headbutt is invariably prevalent.
It's going to happen.
We saw it in Chavez-Randall, two final seconds of round eight, the two clashing heads. Chavez bleeding profusely, and the point deduction cost Randall the title. Round eight marches on. The push by Lopez. Oh, a left, sweeping left by Chavez. And that eye gets worse and worse for Lopez.
It is just closing more and more. I mean, in another couple of rounds, he's just going to have a little slit to look through.
I think he's got a little slit to look through right now.
And it's hard enough with two eyes against Chavez.
I mean, the guy in the side of his face is just coming apart. Oh, nice shot. By
right hand.
Hasn't been bleeding very badly, but the swelling is just getting enormous.
Oh, left hand. Oh, and Chavez is tagged, but he's able to skip away. But he got the worst of the blow. Chavez unloading. Short, crisp left hook by Chavez again. Bothers him. Chavez likes the competitive spirit.
Right there. He's coming in for you. Bam, bam. Left to right hand, left hook. Stand still, man.
Tuck it in.
Don't
tuck
get in the corner. Get out of the corner. I don't want you stuck in the corner.
Round nine. How much time does Lopez have left, particularly with that eye?
Well, the referee said one more round again, meaning no further damage was caused, and he gave one more. The corner said thank you, and they went back to giving him advice again, so they're not too worried about it.
I think for right now, the doctor's basically giving him on a round-by-round lease, that as long as he holds in, he'll let him continue.
I agree with that. There wasn't any damage inflicted in that last round. You know, he eased up on him, did Chavez, and so therefore they gave him another round.
Lopez's closed left eye becoming a major factor here with the going of round nine. Some blood on the bridge of Chavez's nose, but that is nothing new.
Always is.
Yeah, always. Seems like every fight we do.
You can't heal that. That's a scar that doesn't heal on the bridge of the nose.
A very game, Tony Lopez. His left eye in dire trouble. Continues to stand right in against the champion, Julio Cesar Chavez.
Chavez has calmed down the pace a little bit. I'm kind of surprised.
Me too. I thought he was on the way to knocking him out or stopping him. And he's calmed down.
Lopez got his attention too, giving him some credit in the last round. He hit him with a few great straight right hands, but Chavez is Chavez and just shook him off.
Chavez 92-1-1 with the updated record, 79 knockouts. Tony Lopez 45-4-1, 32 knockouts. Chavez now bouncing around. More movement. There's that jab. Chavez boxes.
A little bit of a switch. Tony Lopez coming forward. Chavez boxing, moving.
Those punches, you got to wonder about the steam on Lopez's punches. Wild miss to the left by Chavez.
It's almost amazing that he's coming forward and fighting after the kind of shellacking he's been taking.
Lopez punished, and you can see the damage over the left eye.
I think the eye is really closing now.
Body shots by Chavez. Less than 30 seconds, round nine.
As we've seen in the past, too, Chavez takes whatever he wants to take the time. He takes some time off. He takes a round off, but then he comes back twice as hard in the next round.
That's a battered face of a man who's been absorbing major league punishment.
A flurry by Chavez. And then he backs off as the bell sounds.
And see, he's looking at the referee. Chavez looked at the referee. Come on. Come on. Do I have to keep hitting this guy? That's very nice of him.
Catch him.
You have to back him up. Besides that, when you back him up, he's
all right, one more round.
One more round.
No more.
You know he's working for it. You're squaring off.
You hear it clearly. One more round, the doctor said. Clearly. This relentless beating that just doesn't stop. Even Chavez seems to have slowed up in sympathy with the fighters. It's almost like saying, well, the doctor will stop it. I don't have to do more, but it's now the 11th. And the doctor has said one more each time. A 10th round, I'm sorry.
Yeah, even Chavez turned to the referee, Luis Carlos Guzman, and said, how much more damage you want me to inflict on this man?
Yeah, he shook his head as if to say, come on, what do you want me to do, kill him?
Well, it continues into round 10. All Julio Cesar Chavez.
The problem is the other eye is now closing and it's cut as well. So you're talking about a left and a right eye.
A large welt forming around the edge of the right eye now of Tony Lopez. So both eyes in trouble. Get
Yeah, that eye's really getting to the point where it's just any time now they could stop and it would be very much justified. It's not like Tony Lopez is really in the fight.
Perhaps one more barrage or flurry by Chavez and it could be over. There's a heavy right hand by Chavez, but once again, a courageous Lopez looking to reply. He's got a lot of heart, there's no question. Right hand smacking Lopez. Chavez taking a little step back and as if to say, what do I have to do for this fight to be over?
And he's right. When a guy is that far gone, all right, that's good. That's it. That is it.
No much, said the doctor.
Sacagawa said, meaning that's it. That's finished, and well, it should be. The most relieved man in this place is Julio Cesar Chavez, who really did not want to beat him further.
Chavez providing some consolation and sympathy for the challenger, Tony Lopez. And you get the feeling he really liked the competitive juices and spirit of Tony Lopez. So Chavez, hoisted to the shoulders of his people, goes to 93 1-1 with 80 knockouts. And Tony Lopez will have his eyes checked out. Lopez goes to 45-5-1. And in the fight of his life, it just didn't happen. The last punch of the second round opened up the cut over the left eye of Tony Lopez, and it was downhill from there.
Yeah, it really was. I think it wasn't just that it was downhill because of the cut. The cut wasn't as bad as the swelling was. And, you know, Tony Lopez is a tough kid. I think Chavez really likes him. He appeared to be able to do more damage if he wanted to and didn't appear to want to.
So it's 93 down, 7 to go for 100 victories. Julio Cesar Chavez really wanted to do this in front of his hometown fans, able to retain his WBC super lightweight title, his second defense in his second reign. 3-0 since his first and only taste of defeat against Frankie Randall. Chavez beats three-time world champion Tony the Tiger Lopez, who loses out in his first bid for the super lightweight title. So Lopez now makes the journey back to Sacramento, while Chavez has the much shorter trip to Culiacan, Mexico, to map out his plans for the near future, what has been labeled the final journey, finishing up his business by the end of 1995 with 100 fights at least. So Julio Cesar Chavez goes to 93-1-1 with 80 knockouts. So big crowd in the ring. All around Julio Cesar Chavez. We're standing by for the official word. And Jimmy Lennon Jr. has just that. Jimmy.
Damas y caballeros, tenemos el tiempo, 1 minuto 41 segundos en round número 10 with a time of 1 minute 41 seconds in round number 10. The physician at ringside advises to stop this contest. The winner by way of technical knockout, el doctor terminó la pelea, el ganador por knockout técnico, el gran campeón mexicano, Julio Cesar Chavez.
So there you have it, Julio Cesar Chavez. All business here tonight, Bobby, and once he opened up that cut, there's no question.
Yeah, it was no question after the cut, and I don't even think it was so much the cut. Tony couldn't get to him with the right hand, couldn't hurt him as much as Frankie Randall has appeared to in the past, and just wasn't as effective, wasn't as accurate, and Chavez too strong, and just, again, search and destroy, and that's what he does.
Yeah, I thought it might be a closer fight coming in, but although Julio enjoyed the competitive nature of Tony the Tiger Lopez, he was outclassed, clearly.
Yeah, and I think Tony is so tough that he would have gone the distance, but again, the cuts, kind of the right thing to do. Why subject him to all that punishment?
All right, Bobby, let's go up to the fight, Dr. Purdy.
I'm standing here with the governor of Nuevo León, who must be very proud of his people showing up.
Very proud and very happy.
How did you like the fight?
We are champion with Julio Cesar.
Where is this?
The city of champions.
Is this the first time you've seen him fight in person?
Yes, of course.
Thrilling, is it?
Yes, and I am really very proud of Julio Cesar. And I'm very proud of Monterrey.
Yes.
As you know, Monterrey is the best city, the best industrial capital, the industrial capital city of Mexico.
I know, my family lives here. So I know. I have Felix Guzman lives there. So, all right. Now, Miss Gladys, ask him if he was holding back from hitting him because...
No, lo que pasa es que me hace días sufrí un desgarre muscular en el brazo izquierdo, en el brazo derecho, y realmente sentía mucho miedo soltar los golpes con toda mi fuerza, porque sentía que lo fallaba y se me iba. Hace días que me inyectaron los dos brazos y no, estaba peleando medio gas, dile.
He says he was fighting not completely well because several days ago he had to be injected. He certainly had an injury to the muscle in his arm, and so he was holding back himself. His left arm was hurting a great deal during the fight.
Did you find him very difficult to fight?
No, lo que pasa es que estaba peleando a medio gas, no estaba dando todo lo mío.
He wasn't fighting full steam, he wasn't giving his all to this one. He was only half of what he usually
is.
He says, although he confided in himself too much and he took a right hand.
Muchacho muy valiente.
He says he's a very valiant fighter, however.
Fire.
He didn't need translation.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Eso no necesita traducción.
Como siempre, mañana nos vemos en Culiacán a la 1:00 p.m.
He says, as always, he will be in Culiacán tomorrow.
Tomorrow, Culiacán. Una.
Celebras muy, muy feliz Navidad.
Una feliz Navidad y un próspero año para todo México. Gracias.
Very Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
And here's another
Merry. Finals. Very, very strong.
Thank you. Thank you much for the chance to paddle. Thank you, Chavez.
No problem, Tony. Thank you very much.
And a happy champion goes. And we talk to Tony Lopez. If we can get people out of the way here. Emmanuel, shame on you. Emmanuel. And found it very tough with this man.
You know what? Actually, you know what? Taking nothing away from him. He's still a great champion. He always has been. But it wasn't still that tough. Still wasn't as... I thought I was doing a good job. I wanted to continue. I didn't think I've had worse cuts. I mean, you know, you know that.
Yes, we have seen those.
Yeah, I mean, you know, so.
But you weren't winning the fight. You weren't. You know, at the point you weren't even close by then.
No.
So not much chance.
Yeah, but you know, boxing. I only get warmed up at the 10th round.
We saw that in the first fight.
Yeah, you know that. That's how I am. I always come back in the last two rounds. That's how I am. But I just never got a chance today.
Well, you. You did very well for what you could do. I think he felt a little sorry for you that last round. He said to the referee, why don't you stop this? You got these cuts. I don't want to hurt him.
Yeah, but the cuts weren't bad. I mean, you see me worse than this. I mean, this is nothing. The punch wasn't hurting. I mean, I was fine. Other than my cuts,
you're a deep satisfaction to every vampire in America. Seeing you fight, you see nothing but blood every time you fight.
Oh, yeah. I come here to win fights, and that's what I do. And,
yes.
And you know, maybe this time it didn't go by, but maybe... Mr. King will give me another shot at it.
Absolutely.
So,
I think you're a terrific fighter. You proved to the crowd and everyone else, you fulfilled the prophecy. You came in, you fought. And I appreciate that and I respect that. Everybody who fights on my card fights. And was fighting the best. I'm proud of you and most certainly I'll do everything I can to bring you back.
All right. Thank you.
All right. Have a good Christmas and a happy new year. And let's go back to Steve Albert at ringside.